Hi, this is Debbie, and I'm sharing a video I created for my Doodling with Debbie series for Simon Says Stamp. Today I'm using a couple of the new sets from the Love You release from Simon Says Stamp, and with a glass jar and a glass light bulb to colour, I'll be chatting about how to approach watercolouring glass. So here's the two sets I'll be using today. These are both large 6x8 inch sets with lots of fun images to play with and sentiments to go with them too. I did a quick Google search for jar lights and saw a number of fun ones with a bulb hanging from the jar lid and others where flowers tumbled out the top, so I thought I'd combine the two. I used a piece of Fabriano extra white cold press watercolour card I lifted from the gum block with the aid of a palette knife and placed it in the Misty. I stamped the flower bunch from the You Have My Heart set in antique linen distress ink and followed up with a jar from the Light Me Up set. I didn't stamp the whole jar as the top would be covered by the flowers. I tried to guess how much of the jar I needed to stamp, but didn't quite get it right with the line of the jar overlapping some of the leaves on the left. You could, if you wish, mask the flowers, but by the time I'd finished painting this piece, you can't see the line through the leaves. I finished up by stamping the light bulb hanging from the jar lid. I taped the watercolour piece to my craft mat with painter's tape, and this will help to prevent it warping when I start adding lots of water. Today I use Daniel Smith paints, in particular Undersea Green, Crinacridone Coral and Crinacridone Gold. This card is quite busy with lots of leaves, flowers, the jar, the light bulb, etc. And so I kept the watercolouring quite simple. I picked a leaf and used a brush loaded with paint and added a smidgen of the paint to the shadow area of the leaf, and then used a second brush with just plain water, just plain clear water, to pull out the colour over the rest of the area. The same was true for the flowers. I added the darker, more concentrated paint to the nooks of the flowers and then pulled out the colour with a damp brush. I've painted flowers like these a lot, so it's nothing new. You can see similar flower painting videos on mine and Simon's YouTube channels. However, it isn't that often that I paint glass, and certainly not for quite some time. I don't profess to be an expert on watercolour and glass, far from it, but I thought you'd find it interesting to see my process and how I slowly worked out a method for painting glass. For the filament of the bulb, I initially painted a darker orange, but then it seemed too dark, so I dabbed off some of the colour with a paper towel and then went over it with a lighter yellow. The little heart icon, I painted a concentrated Crinacridone Coral to match with the flowers. I'm not sure whether the heart works upside down, but I still couldn't paint it any other colour than red. I knew with the stamped outline I would have to make the edge of the light bulb darker, which would then mean there would be lighter areas over the bulb itself. And this would be true of the jar also. I decided not to add water to my jar. Light bulbs and water mixing just didn't seem like a good idea. The poor flowers were just going to have to cope. So eliminating water from the equation made things a little simpler. However, I still had the jar reflections and the colour of the light bulb to take into account. The edge of the jar needed to be defined from the background, so I wanted to get some paint down there, which I then blended out with a wet brush. I don't like super realistic, but I do like nods to realism, so I added the impression of the base of the jar with shadows, again all blended out with lots of water. I added light washes of yellow in areas over the jar as if the colour from the light bulb was reflecting off the glass. As I started to deepen the colour on the different areas of the jar, I kept some areas lighter to act as reflections. So I deepened and deepened the shadows until I thought if I went too much further, the glass wouldn't look clear any longer. I added a light shadow for the jar to sit on and washes of light yellow with pops of stronger colour to warm up the background with the light coming from the light bulb. I then dried the piece and removed the tape from the card before placing it in the Misty, and I stamped a greeting from the Light Me Up set in VersaFine Clair Nocturne ink. Although I stamped it twice, the texture of the card meant I didn't get a full impression. I debated stamping the sentiment again, but didn't want to lose the definition on the delicate font, and so instead I took a black pen and filled in any missing parts. I trimmed the panel to be slightly smaller than a 5x7 card base, and used foam adhesive to add it to a card cut and scored from Nina Desert Storm in the 100-pound weight. I debated adding sequins, but in the end decided to add a few freehand leaves to fill out the bouquet of flowers. I used light paint mixes for the leaves so that they appeared as if they were in the background. The other thing I debated was whether to add splatter to this card. I liked how it looked, but you know me, I love splatter, and a piece just doesn't seem to be finished until I'd added the perfect pearls and white gouache splatter. I also added a few droplets of leftover paint too, and then finally I called it done. And so there you go, my look at how to paint glass in this card with both a glass jar and a light bulb to consider. I'll leave links in the YouTube description to the products that I've used today, as well as a coordinating link to the blog post over at limedudadesign.com. I want to thank you for joining me today, and if you've enjoyed this tutorial, I'd be delighted if you'd give it a thumbs up and to subscribe to this channel. Also, if you'd like to get notified when a new video is out, don't forget to hit the bell button next to the subscribe button too. Thanks, and I'll see you next time.